the phenomenon of spectrum harmonics overtones through preparation. Multiphonics by Java Africa. Last Pieces by Feldman. ASAP, as slow as possible. John! She is asleep, the wonderful widow. Prepare piano and voice. Let it play. Terry, let it play. And look to these names on that poster of this night. Stockhausen, intuitive music. Spontaneous, unforeseen. Not a concept, not repeatable. Not a prefixed time of duration. The influence of the listener, the hall, the expectations, condition of the self-performing artist. Today. I don't want to play. Of course, you can stay. Have nothing to say. I welcome whatever happens next, okay? Don't know how long. Don't know how to begin and from where. Who can I ask for? John! Are you there?
Making everything worse.
You can't. A good and evil go together in the same way that life and death go together. You can't have a half of the whole. The function of avant-garde, is it still the same like 30 years ago? Do you think that radical provocations through art is still possible today? I don't think of the avant-garde as radically provocative. I think that it is rather like invention or discovery, and that we need those ways of acting in order to, not in order to leave the past and the present and go into the future.
Is it important for you to be understood by many people with your intention and musical result? Or do you accept to be interpreted by the specialists and experts?
I don't work with intention. I work with non-intention. And I don't expect to be understood, but I'm rather certain of being experienced.
There are several John Cage in my life. Riedel's Cage, Feldman's Cage, Schoening's Cage, Metzger's, and my prepared piano cage. Quite different ones. Which one are you the most?
Well, I'm not any one of those. I am the one who hasn't yet done anything. I don't know what I've done, and I'm looking to see what I must do.
And do you find sense in improvising music?
Most of my life I've not been interested in improvisation, but in, let's say, the last 10 or 15 years, I've become interested.
And I've written a number of pieces that require it. I try to make the improvisation such that the musician doesn't have recourse to his memory or his taste, but makes some kind of discovery in the course of the improvisation.
Is the prepared piano a product of improvisation or a product of writing and composing?
Well, first it was the making of an instrument. And then when I was writing the sonatas and interludes, I started with certain preparations, and as I tried not to add any new ones unless I absolutely needed it. And naturally now and then I needed it. So that I tried to use the instrument which I had rather than changing it. But I did change it.
Did you have any kind of association of Indonesian or African sounds, percussive sounds, when you did that? I mean, you worked with Lou Harrison and did the research.
The very first piece I wrote for a prepared piano was written for a black dancer, Sibylla Ford. Mm. And she had made a very African dance. And it was in looking for that kind of sound that I discovered the effect of putting objects between the strings. But subsequently my interest became not so exotic as just for the sound. In the sonatas and interludes, I remember thinking quite consciously of a sound that would suggest the Orient, together with the sound that would suggest Europe. And if you don't hold down the una corda in the sonatas and interludes, you get a sound of bells, which I connect with Europe. But if you do hold down the you get drum-like sounds that are connected with the Orient.
Regarding pieces like Freeman Etudes, to overcome difficulties in performing difficult music as a symbol for to overcome difficulties in life, to learn difficult pieces as a symbol for
to do the impossible. It becomes a model for changing the world.
The work about Martin Seligman?
Well, that was a great loss, his death in early September. I received a call early in the summer from Abby Scherer, one of his friends in California. And she said, Marty is sick. And I asked her where he was, and she said, he's at home in Buffalo. So I called him, and I said, I hear you're sick. What is the trouble? And he said, you really want to know? And then he told me that he had cancer. And that it was in the stomach, and that he had an 80% chance of recovery. And he went through that kind of treatment with chemistry and radiation for 2 weeks, and then a rest for 2 weeks without the treatment. And during one of those resting periods, he went to the Home Festival, and I think someplace else. And then the next thing I knew, when I called him in Buffalo, was that he was not at home, but was in the hospital. And when I called him there, he said there are complications. And the complications were was such that the cancer got into the lungs. In the newspaper, when after he died, they said it was pancreatic cancer. Before he died, he said, as Marcel Duchamp said in that book Entretien with Cabane, Duchamp said, I have no regrets, speaking of his old life. And Martin Feldman said the same thing. And he said, connecting himself with me, he said, we've had a good life. And I don't regret anything.
Do you remember when you played the 5 piano piece in Berlin in 72?
Yes.
And you needed 20 minutes longer than the other before?
Marty never wrote that way again. He never gave that kind of feeling.
I was in that concert, I saw him sweating.
He didn't
and
like it.
You were playing and going, playing with the tension that the world was in his feet.
Thank you. Thank you.
remove everything out of the instrument, then afterwards I show to the tuner that I didn't harm the instrument, everything stayed in tune. And if you are liking, just come up here and look.